So my name is Adam Feinberg. I'm an assistant professor in the departments of biomedical engineering and material science and engineering. My group is the regenerative biomaterials and therapeutics group here at Carnegie Mellon University. And we work on biomaterials and different tissue engineering strategies that we apply to the heart and the cornea and skeletal muscle. We've been developing technologies to help improve the surfaces of biomaterials and control the way cells attach to them and grow and improve their interaction. We call it POT, or patterning on topography, and it's a way of taking chemistry, different kinds of proteins, and patterning them on surfaces in complex geometries that can control the way cells grow and interface with that surface. The surface of a lot of different biomaterials that you put into the body are rough. You can think about sandpaper, and cells respond to that, but sandpaper is random. There's no way or direction for how cells should grow or behave. Traditionally, there's been two different ways of kind of controlling the way cells interact with the surface. You can either have what they call microtopography, or very small features like squares or ridges or bumps on the surface that cells will see. They're kind of the same size of cells, and cells will move around and interact with those features. There's also another technique where you can stamp proteins onto a surface, kind of like when you would stamp a lion or tiger on the construction paper as a kid, but we stamp proteins instead. And what we came up with was a way to essentially stamp onto a flat surface and pattern proteins, and then put that onto a rough surface, and then push that pattern protein onto the rough surface in arbitrary directions. And that's how we created this POT, or patterning on topography technique. What we want to do is improve the surfaces of biomaterials used on devices in the body. This could be stents, this could be urinary catheters, this could be pacemaker leads. Things that we know that we put in the body, they work well for a short period of time, but after a while they start to fail. And a lot of that failure is based on the way the cells interact with the material at a very fundamental level. But now with our technique, with this POT, or patterning on topography technique, we can potentially combine multiple factors, chemistry, topography, together in new ways that we hope will improve long-term performance and extend the lifetime of devices to improve interfacing with the body. And that's probably anywhere from 5 to 10 years out into the future.